Okay, Google, one cheeseburger, please.
One cheeseburger, that will be €2. You can use the coin slot now.
Okay, Google, customer validated.
The machine has received your money. Your order is dispensing now. Thank you for using ElectryDragonite's automated vending machine.
This is actually working. It feels really good to say that, as it took some work to get here. This is a Lego McDonald's machine with an integrated Google Home Mini. You simply tell the machine what you want, and it gives you a price. You can make any kind of combination between cheeseburgers, veggie juniors, french fries, and Coca Cola. So how did I get this to work? Well, I managed to create a simple link between Lego Mindstorms NXT and the Google Assistant. As there is no official way to make these devices work together, I had to come up with my own idea, which incorporates using Wi-Fi plugs and a Nintendo 3DS. I'll show you the complete setup later in this video.
Okay, Google, one vegetarian menu, please.
Processing. One veggie junior meal that will be a total of €6. You can use the coin slot now. Please place a cup under the Coca Cola faucet.
Okay, Google, customer validated.
The machine has received your money. Your order is dispensing now. Thank you for using ElectryDragonite's automated vending machine.
So, how does this work? In short, this works by utilizing Google Home custom routines, a few Wi-Fi plugs compatible with Google Home, a few bulbs, two Lego Mindstorms NXTs, one Nintendo 3DS, a small speaker, and then one Google Home Mini. Yes, that is a bit of a mixture, but trust me, every single device has its own important function. This is just what I had laying around. And you could easily swap many of these devices out with different things, like swapping Google Assistant for Alexa. I wasn't sponsored by any companies to make this video. However, if you are a company wanting to collaborate, I'd love to get in touch. So let's start from the beginning, when you activate the Google Home Mini. First, let's take a look inside the settings page in the Google Assistant Android app. This doesn't work on iOS, so I used an Android emulator for PC, which works just fine. In here, we can create custom routines, meaning you can make the assistant react to certain phrases. In our case, that will be all the ways you order the food. So once we've created a custom react phrase, we need to make that command do something. And it's actually very simple. Every single food option turns on a separate Wi-Fi plug with a bulb connected. So in the Google, here's the phrase, one cheeseburger please, or any of these other ways of saying it, it turns on bulb number 2. It then proceeds to say the custom phrase.
One cheeseburger, that will be €2. You can use the coin slot now.
And then it turns off the bulb again. Now we have to go into the Lego Mindstorms side of things. The first NXT has 4 separate light sensors just beside each Wi-Fi plug bulb. In this way, the NXT knows when the customer has ordered something through the Google Home Mini. So when the light number 2 is turned on, the NXT knows that the customer wants a cheeseburger. Since this NXT is already out of ports, I had to add another NXT so we can have some way of sensing the coins. Through Bluetooth, it receives a phrase from the first NXT saying cheeseburger. When the NXT number 2 has received the signal, it turns on the red light on the front of the machine and waits for a coin to be inserted. That is also using a light sensor. When the 2 euro coin passes, it sees a change in light intensity and then activates the next part of the program. This is where the almighty Nintendo 3DS comes into play. The 3DS is connected to the external speaker at the front of the machine. With a servo motor, the NXT number 2 presses the A button on the 3DS, which repeats a local audio file I put into the Nintendo 3DS. It says,
"Okay Google, customer validated."
This is another of those custom phrases inside the Google Assistant app. This is no real function for the machine. It's just a way of adding more service to the machine. So when the Google Assistant hears this phrase, it just repeats the same custom phrase every time.
The machine has received your money. Your order is dispensing now. Thank you for using ElectryDragonite's automated vending machine.
So if the customer says this phrase, nothing really happens security-wise for the machine. 3 seconds later, it sends a signal back to the first NXT, which will then activate the motor for the cheeseburgers. And that is one entire transaction. It is the same process for every single option. So here's an example for the entire cheeseburger menu option.
One cheeseburger menu, please.
Processing.
Bolt number 2 turns on. Bolt number 1 turns on. Bolt number 4 turns on. The NXT now knows that we want 3 items.
You can use the coin slot now. Please prepare a cup under the Coca Cola faucet.
The NXT 2 is now ready to accept coins. The NXT 2 sends us a total of 6 euros. The NXT 1 taps the A button on the 3DS.
Okay, Google, customer validated.
Google Home says back the custom phrase.
The machine.
NXT 2 activates motor for cheeseburger and soda. NXT 1 activates motor for fries.
Thank you for using ElectryDragonite's automated vending machine.
It does take a long time for the soda to fill up. In the meantime, I'll tell you how it works. The soda pump kind of works like a compressor. It builds up pressure inside the sealed water bottle, and the only way for pressure to escape the bottle is to go through the faucet pipe, which is sunk underwater. This gives us a slow but steady way of dispensing the liquid. I've used this mechanism many times in my past videos, but this time I managed to create a better seal by supergluing connector rods to the bottle cap, instead of just gluing the flexible pipes. This also makes it a lot easier to refill. So here near the end, I'd like to answer some common questions. Why McDonald's? Well, it seems like you guys are really into McDonald's, so I figured, why not? Were you inspired by anyone? I was definitely inspired by Nipe Nipe. His McDonald's machine is really worthwhile watching if you haven't seen it already. And as I said back on the day of its release, it is what I believe to be the next step for Lego vending machines. Why didn't you use the EV3? Because I have more ports for motors and sensors with a dual NXT setup. I was considering using an EV3 because it is a bit better for playing audio files. But it wasn't good enough, so I had to make a workaround with the Frankenstein 3DS setup. How does the NXTs communicate back to the Google Home? Really, they don't. The Google Home is a dumb device in this question. All it really does is turn on and off bulbs with the custom commands. The phrase customer validated can be said by a customer, although without any effect. Can you use other coins than a 2 euro coin? Anything smaller in diameter is rejected by the coin rejection, so technically yes. Thank you so much for watching this video. Hopefully there won't be another year before my next upload. although I can't really promise anything. The current plan is that I upload whenever I have something good to share with you guys. So, see you in the next video, and once again, thank you so much for watching.
Okay, Google, we're about to end.
Oh no, I can't believe it's already over. Thank you for watching this video. Be sure to smash like and subscribe.